love it. You got to find a way to ring that bell. Then you can have a little self-satisfied grin. Right now, a little more determination is needed.
Boy, left that first defender grasping at air as he winds up getting a full 8 yards on that play. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up.
We'll get an update when we come back to Miami.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
That's caught. Waddle on the left side.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Looking to throw. Cantrell right back to Jalen Waddle for another catch.
The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
They'll look to throw again. And oh, it'll be intercepted.
And the Colts are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line.
And as we've seen, points have been precious so far, and they just threw some away on that snap. And look, let's face it, as we advance further into this game, that play will be on the minds of everyone who's watching it. They wonder if this is the turning point. Is this the spot where those points were given away? It could cost them a ball game.
And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
Back to Taylor on first down.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
Play action. Now Richardson.
Left sideline, a dime, and it looks like he's got it. Could we get a touchdown in his first half after all? It's first and 10.
And Richardson back to throw it.
He finds his man complete. That's Stanley. And he quickly clocks it, and they're going to have a good shot at getting 3 here before the break.
Here's 2nd and 10. A final shot before the half. Richardson. Oh, and that is incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball. But he was unable to get away from the defender. Couldn't create space. Couldn't uncover at the end of the route. And that one winds up incomplete.
And his kick is good. And that will do it for this first half.
Halftime over, no problem with us. We skip right to the third quarter and continue this midseason contest.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter.
The Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter.
Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now, they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
Brought down that time by Quay Walker. Ball spotted at the 45. Here's a second and seven.
Back to throw. Cantrell.
Quick hitter to Jalen Waddle.
And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Looking to throw. Cantrell. They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early.
So pass interference, the call there. Always, obviously, Charles, such a subjective call. You agree with the penalty?
Well, from where we're standing right now, I think the officials are tightening things up here in the second half. Maybe a defender gets away with that in the first, but this time the flag comes out, and I think it's a good call.
Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. Off the play fake. Cantrell. This will be caught inside the 10. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
The kicker fest so far. All points via field goals. They're hoping to change that right here.
Off the bootleg. Cantrell. Pass incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you.
And they're going to get him. They bring him down to sack back at the 16-yard line. And that sack brings up fourth and goal, a loss of seven. Big play.
I know nowadays they give a lot of guys different things when they get to the sidelines after creating a big play, but just throw a cape on this guy because he single-handedly ended multiple drives. Interception earlier, sack on third down. Really should have been a game for this guy to contain him because he's affecting this game in so many ways.
So they were facing the deficit coming out of the locker room at intermission, and at least they're able to get the field goal to cut into that deficit.
Yeah, now your offense feels pretty good about itself, right? A little bit more up to speed coming out of the break. You turn to your defense now and say, hey, we got three there. We're chipping into the lead. Can you help us out? Holder must get the ball back for us.
So here are the Colts to take over. They are working on that very impressive nine-game win streak, looking to get it to 10 as they've got the lead here, first and 10. A good gain of nine before he's brought down at the 28.
Now, that's a run that warms a play caller's heart because you're actually set up to do whatever you want on offense. You can come right back and run essentially the same play because you have momentum, or you can fake that running play and throw something deep over the top, or you now feel like you have an extra down to play with because if you go ahead and just throw it and you don't get it, come back and try and pick it up on third down. And, Brandon, you know that expression, he just does what he does? It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL, and all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
And he'll scratch out only about a yard after the 32.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And he'll work this one up to about the 38.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They'll try and run for the first with Taylor.
And at a 42-yard line here, brought down there. A gain of four that time as the drive continues. So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. They run once more with Taylor. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. 98 yards rushing for him so far as this terrific season continues here. This will be the 8th play of the drive, and it's 3rd and inches. Give to Bigsby on the option. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. They get 5, and it will go ahead and move the chains. First down, Indianapolis. And as they come to the line, they will not be back now in Miami. It's the Colts. They've got control of the football. They also have the lead as we start the 4th. First and 10, it's Bigsby. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right in a yard.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the 4th quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
As I take a look at the clock, I realize that this drive has eaten up a good portion of the 4th quarter already. Got to tell you, partner, when you're trying to salt away a game, this is exactly what it's supposed to look like.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. They brought him in off the corner, and he gets in to drop him for a loss of 4.
He found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
And once again, the Dolphin defense holds firm as they'll stop him behind the line of scrimmage.
And now a stoppage, and looks like we have a Colt who was shaken up on that last play.
We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. This offense, 2 for 2 on 3rd downs on this drive. They're in for a tough test here, though, 3rd and long. Richardson working from the gun. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. This to make it a 2-score game. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. And the lead stretches to 9. It's now 12-3.
So that's, CD, an important one here in the 4th quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a 2-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a 2-score game, and they were able to get it done.
Miami set to take over. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a 2-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly.
On 1st and 10, Cantrell.
He'll dump this off to Achan.
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Operating from the gun, Cantrell.
Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. On 3rd down, Cantrell. And that is incomplete.
But plain and simple, That's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped. Surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to it? Maybe his rhythm is just off. He's got thrown off. He's got to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Now a stoppage here as it looks like we've got a Dolphin shaking up on the play. We'll get an update when we come back to Miami. Now a second and 10. Achane gets it from the gun. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
They'll run for it with Achane. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. So from the 37, here's a 2nd and 4. Back to throw. Cantrell. That's going to be caught by Waddle. And Waddle going to have a Dolphins first down as he'll get this down to the 30-yard line. Looking to throw. Cantrell. This will be caught, Judy. And he's brought down after a very nice game. Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's 1st and goal. And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sacked back at the 9-yard line. So they've been in the red zone 3 times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on 2nd and goal? Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, 4th quarter, maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there, the leg still there? This has been a tough game. Now the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Here's a big one. It's 4th and goal. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
Illegal touching. Offense.
Boy, so that one, Charles, is a crusher. Take away the touchdown.
Yeah, and that's where defenders, Brandon, really use the sideline to their advantage, because if you can influence the receiver to step out of bounds, you know he can't be the first to touch it when he re-enters the field of play, and that's going to cost him 6 points.
A solid stiff arm, and he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. That good for 22 and a 1st down. 1st down, Colts. Another run by Bigsby. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last 2 plays. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. 5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on 1st down. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. 2nd down, here's a run with Bigsby. And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. This is a big 3rd down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now Richardson. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Whether that's a little grabbing, a little hand fighting, by any means necessary on 3rd down, he was able to get the job done in the secondary and swat that one away.
And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. So the Dolphins now down by 9, a minute 44 to go. And they're in danger of a third straight loss as they come up on 1st and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Cantrell. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Glover. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds.
Now 2nd and 4.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4.
Back to throw. Cantrell. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
From the gun on 3rd down, Cantrell. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
Well, there's a time and a place for everything. Down 2 scores late in the 4th. I get it. Now is the time to throw it downfield, but that one might just write an end to this ball game.
Yeah, I hear all the time how critical I am of play calls. Not in this situation. No other choice, really. Look at the clock. Look at the scoreboard. Had to press it and take a chance.
2nd and long, but you got to figure this almost certainly another run.
Now a handoff to Bigsby. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
They'll get a couple yards back, but not more than that. They'll be left with 12 yards to go on 3rd down.
We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a 1st down. Try to take this home. They'll run. And he is going to have a Colts 1st down. And that should be the run that finishes this game off. Bigsby once more.
And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Here's a give to Bigsby.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis.
Take Bigsby. His 2nd rushing touchdown on the year. And the Colts add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week.
You get in a 2nd and long situation down here in the red zone, I'd say most defensive coaches would think pass, let's bring some pressure. So this is kind of a tendency breaker here to hit him with something on the ground, and he'll take it all the way into the end zone.
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. One final shot. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And this will be caught at the 30. And a little bit of a consolation prize here. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
The extra point here is good, but the late touchdown can only draw the score a bit closer as this game is over. Well, on the one side, if you try to take...
Let me know what you wanna do. If you wanna build, I'm Bobby.